Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you again how to grow your crystals and make beautiful silicon druzy molds with it. And this time I'm going to use a polymer clay and a molding dough for the base mold. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of silicon mold making in this case, but I also have tutorials of resin, acrylics, mixed media and a lot more, consider to subscribe and click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So what I already mentioned, I'm using a polymer clay, and I already baked it in an oven for 30 minutes, and now I'm adding the wood glue on top of it. So it's a different way of making the base mold than I've shown in previous videos. And again, I'm going to use the alum salt on top of it. There you can see it. So if you don't have the base molds that I've shown in my previous videos, you can make them yourself with polymer clay. And I'm using the Fimo Soft Glay, and it needs to be baked in an oven for 30 minutes, and then your base mold is done. So we are 24 hours later, and the wood glue is dry now, so now I can add the first mixture, and again it's the same ratio as I used in my previous videos. It's 400 milliliters of water and 200 gram of alum salt. There you can see it. And the rule is to add that much alum salt that it doesn't dissolve anymore. So if it still dissolves, then you need to add more. And then I mix it around. There you can see it. Need to add a little bit more. So I made the base mold out of polymer clay, and you can make any shape you want, and that's nice, because then you don't have only round base molds, but you can make any shape that you want with the polymer clay. And I can imagine that some people can't buy the base molds that I've shown in my previous videos. So that's why I show you a different way of making the base mold. I still need to add more of the alum salt. And it's not a powder. It's the particles are much larger than a powder, because I got some questions. And this is not a powder, it's a salt, alum salt. So I added some links in the description below this video. And it's a comparable alum salt that I'm using. Again, it needs to be strained, because if there are still particles of the salt in the mixture, you don't want to add that on top of your base mold. So there you can see it, straining the mixture. And it's hot water, I boiled it. And that way you can grow your crystals. There you can see the base molds. I put it in a bin, plastic bin or a tray, and then I add on top, I'm adding the mixture. There you can see it. So also this is a different way of adding the mixture. And then it needs to be in the mixture for 24 hours. So we are 24 hours later, and now I can take a look if there are some crystals already grown. So I take it out, and you can use this mixture again by boiling it again. And I always check if I can add more alum salt. So I'm not going to throw away this mixture. And there are also very nice crystals on the bottom of my plastic tray. So I'm going to keep those. I will show you later how they look. There you can see it. A lot of crystals. So I'm going to keep these crystals for other projects. But you can also dissolve them again in the mixture, and then you can use it on top of your base mold. Making it a little bit dry so I have a better look of how large the crystals are. Yeah, and this is a really nice way of growing your own crystals, because you can make the shape as large as you want, because the polymer clay, you can roll it with a rolling pin, and also as thick as you want or as thin. I have it very thin, and then with the wood glue on top of it you can add the alum salt. But I really wanted to show you a different way of making your own base mold. Now I'm going to put it back in my plastic tray, because I want to add a second mixture on top of it, because I want the crystals a little bit larger. And this is a closer look, so you can see after one time of adding the mixture how it looks. Those are the crystals that were in the plastic tray that I'm going to keep. And this is how the shapes look after one time of adding the mixture on top of it. Yeah, it sparkles a lot. But I want the crystals a little bit larger, so I'm going to add a second mixture on top of it, and then let it sit for 24 hours. So this is a long process, but I think it's a great way of growing your crystals and making your own druzy mold. There you can see it, adding it for the second time. So the same ratio, 400 milliliters of water, 200 gram of alum salt. And then you need to let this sit for 24 hours before you can take them out. Putting back the lid on top, not totally closed. And again, we are 24 hours later. I'm very curious how they look. I can already see that the crystals have grown much larger, taking the shapes out of my plastic tray. And they look great. So I'm not going to add a third mixture on top of it. I'm keeping them the way they are now. But yeah, I need to make a mold, because otherwise the silicone rubber will flow away if I don't have a barrier next to it. So I'm going to use a molding dough for that. In a minute I will show you how I do that. First making it dry, and before you add the silicone rubber on top of it, it needs to dry completely because they are now wet from the mixture. And then you need to spray it with a gloss varnish. I'm using the MoTip gloss varnish, and I'm adding three thin layers, because otherwise if you pour your silicone rubber on top of it now, then the crystals will break off. But first I need to let this dry before I can add the gloss varnish and make a mold. So this is a closer look after two times of adding the mixture. I'm pleased how the crystals look, so I will keep it the way they are. Let it dry, spray it with a gloss varnish, and then make the mold with the molding dough. But they look great. I'm very pleased. So now I'm showing you how to make a mold. I'm using a molding dough, and I pressed the shape into the molding dough so that it's stuck on the bottom, and now I'm making a barrier around it, because otherwise the silicon rubber will flow away. There you can see it, pressing it against the crystals, making my barrier. And this molding dough you can use again. It stays soft, because I needed something to hold the shape down so that it will not flow or rise to the top. So that's why I pressed it in the molding dough, and I'm making a barrier with the molding dough. And what I already mentioned, the shapes I've sprayed with a gloss varnish. All the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box below the video with the links to the websites, as I always do. So if you're curious, please check out the description box, because there's a lot of information. So this way you can make any shape that you want. If you don't have the base molds I've used in previous videos, you can make it yourself. Now it's time to pour the silicone rubber into the molds. So bit by bit I'm adding it, not too much, because I want to see how it spreads out, because I don't want to have the molds too thick. And I know the silicone rubber will not stick to the molding dough. Yeah, you can see it bit by bit. I'm adding the silicon rubber, and after 24 hours I will take them out of the base mold, and then we will see how the druzy molds, druzy silicon inlay molds will look. Again, we are 24 hours later. Now I'm going to take the druzy silicon molds out of the base mold. There you can see it. Goes very easy, so that's great. Because it's also an experiment. I didn't know if this would work or not. But the first one is already out, so now I'm going to the second one. And also in this video I'm going to show you how I use these druzy inlay molds in a coaster mold. And the last one. And the molds are still intact, the base mold, so I can pour again in it. And they are really thin, so that's good. A little bit closer, there you can see the sparkle, really nice. Yeah, I'm pleased. So now I'm going to use the silicon druzy inlay mold in a coaster mold. And the only thing I did is I placed them in the coaster mold. And now I'm pouring resin around it. The first color is one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the Navajo. Really nice color. So on the edge I'm going to use this color, and the silicon mold I'm using is from Molds and Shapes. Really great quality silicon molds, and if you're interested, the information is in the description box below this video. I also have a promo code for their new website. My promo code is justpaint5. If you use my code, then you get 5% discount. So that's great. The next color is a Pinata Alcohol Ink Forest Green. And I added a little bit of sparkle. And in this case, I've used the Dazzle Gold. It's not listed yet in my Etsy shop, but it will. In a few weeks, it will also be added to my Etsy shop. And you all know I love sparkle, so that's why I'm adding sparkle in it. The heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And there you can see the druzy shapes that I made in the beginning of the video. And they are really thin. They are about 5 millimeters. So that's great. And the silicon mold is 1 centimeter deep, so that's also okay. So now I'm going to pour on top of the druzy inlay molds. Also the round one I made, that one is available in my Etsy shop. Some clear on top. And I'm also using a Bombay ink in the color Aqua. You can see it. Again, the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. I never use a torch, because then you have a risk that your resin will stick to the silicon mold. Now a darker shade of the Aqua. So I added more drops in my resin and on top some clear to spread it and to create some nice effects. More clear. And hopefully I will get a nice sparkly center or from the druzy inlay molds. More of the darker shade. And clear to push the color down. There you can see it, and to spread it a little bit. I'm also testing a new paste, and this is in the color red bronze, because I want to add some pigment paste to my pigment line. So I'm trying this one out, making a design only on the edge. There you can see it. And I added the colored resin in a Ziploc bag. There you can see it. I'm making my design with it. Also some white paste that I'm testing. So not on top of the druzy inlay mold, only on the edge. And then I'm done with the coasters, need to let this dry before I can take them out of the mold. So we are 1 hour later and I really wanted to show you the effects that I already have. There you can see it, the nice blending of the white and the red copper paste together with the Navajo and the alcohol ink forest green. Now, so far I'm very pleased with this site. It sparkles a lot. Some nice effects in the middle already, in the center. So we are 24 hours later and the coasters are dry. I can take them out. Normally I don't have a problem with that because I don't use a torch. They can see it. Very easy. Need to watch out because they are still a little bit bendy. The last one. And then I need to take the druzy inlay molds out. And this side is looking great, so I would use them on this side. Because on the other side there's a dip of the druzy inlay molds, there you can see it. And the last one goes very easy, no problems. If they leaked, also no problem. You can take away the leakage very much, very easy. Now I'm showing it you. Now I wouldn't use them on this side because there's a dip of the silicone mold. druzy inlay mold, I will use them on this side. So I will add a heat resistant top layer. Also, the link to that is in the description box, because I'm using the Top Pro resin from the Resin Pro company, and it's heat resistant up to 200 degrees, so that's great. But they sparkle a lot, and I'm really pleased with how the colors blended together. In a nice contrast with the white and the red bronze paste. A little bit closer, there you can see it. This is the end result. I added a silver edge. Also, the link to that is in the description box. And I've added a heat resistant top layer. So you can also make your own shape or your own base mold. So if you don't have the base molds, the round ones I've used in my other videos, then you can make them yourself with polymer clay and some molding dough. But I'm very pleased. So let me know what you think of my coasters. I want to thank you all for watching again. And hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye.